So, black holes are not eternal. They evaporate away at an increasing rate until they vanish in a gigantic explosion. Quantum mechanics has allowed particles and radiation to escape from the ultimate prison, a black hole.
Philosophers and poets have asked the question, will the world end in fire or ice? We can now give an answer. The latest evidence shows that the universe is not slowing down, but it's speeding up out of control. And the universe, we think, will die in ice. Trillions upon trillions of years from now.
Empty space itself has energy. In every little cubic centimeter of space, whether or not there's stuff, whether or not there's particles, matter, radiation, or whatever, there is still energy, even in the space itself. And this energy, according to Einstein, exerts a push on the universe.
What is the weird stuff that's accelerating the universe? We call it dark energy. And this stuff is the dominant stuff of the universe. Almost three quarters of the matter energy content of the universe is this dark energy. And we don't know what it is.
Dark energy, unlike matter or radiation, does not dilute away as the universe expands. This has crucial implications for what the universe is going to do in the future.
So what will be the future of the universe? Well, if the dark energy remains dominant and repulsive, the universe will expand forever. Faster and faster and faster with time. A runaway universe.
70% of the energy of the universe resides in empty space, and we don't understand why.
Permission requested.
But we do know what will happen. If that energy continues to be there, the universe will become cold and dark and empty. That's the future as it might be. We don't know, because we don't yet understand the nature of dark energy. Until we do, we won't know the future, we won't even understand our own origins, and that's why we want to know and study this subject.
Thank you. forecast does seem to be for an ever colder, ever emptier universe. But then, of course, we have to ask, could that end lead to a new beginning? And there are ideas whereby what actually is the end of our universe could in some sense be linked to the beginning of a new one.
We've worked out the mathematics, the equations. They seem to say that if you have an atom smasher that can concentrate tremendous amounts of energy at a single point, you can perhaps open up a gateway, a baby universe. Facing the death of everything there is, this perhaps is their only possibility of escape. And this also raises a very intriguing possibility, sheer speculation, of course, that perhaps any universe that has intelligent life in it will create baby universes, will create lifeboats, and proliferate child universes. So an evolution may take among universes in the multiverse. Survival of the fittest may take place. So those universes which do not have intelligent life are infertile. They have no children. But those universes that have mild temperatures, stars like us, would create civilizations that could open up child universes, and they would then proliferate.
After an unimaginable length of time, even the black holes will have evaporated and the universe will be nothing but a sea of photons gradually tending towards the same temperature as the expansion of the universe cools them towards absolute zero. Once the very last remnants of the very last stars have finally decayed away to nothing, and everything reaches the same temperature, the story of the universe finally comes to an end. For the first time in its life, the universe will be permanent and unchanging. Entropy finally stops increasing because the cosmos cannot get any more disordered. Nothing happens, and it keeps not happening forever.
This is a real-life lore video made possible by Squarespace. Make your next move with a beautiful website from Squarespace. This is Earth. You live here on this planet somewhere, and everything that you've ever known is located right here. But just how small exactly is Earth when compared to the scale of the entire universe? Let's start by zooming out to where we can see our nearest cosmic neighbor, the Moon. You may think...
Different sequence of living things following its own pattern of evolution.
As primeval man watched the moon in the night sky, it became to him an object of curiosity. In legend, he tells the story of an old man who, while digging, discovered a small shiny object. As he held it in his hands, it grew and grew, and finally escaped into the sky to become the moon. This is the moon that saw life begin on Earth millions of years ago.
stones from across the night.
By making ourselves very small, perhaps we will see what these rocks have seen, and remember back those billions of years.
Over decades now, geochemists have been measuring lunar samples and Earth samples and found that the chemical signatures of the two are identical in a very special way, and that the elemental isotopes of the two bodies are identical.
The theory can explain so many things about the moon, but it has a huge flaw. It predicts that the moon is mostly made from the Mars-sized planet, that the Earth and the moon are made from different materials. But that's not what we see. The Earth and the moon are actually like identical twins. The genetic code of planets is written in the isotopes of the elements. The Earth and Moon have identical isotopes. That means that the Earth and Moon are made from the same materials. What do you do when faced with the unknown? Question everything.
Warp drive active.
We were making the mistake of thinking that a planet was always going to look like a planet. The giant impact was making something completely new. From the impact vaporizes the surface, the water, the atmosphere, and mixes all of the gases together in just a few hours. The Earth would have been like Jupiter. There's nothing to stand on. A synestia gives us a new way to solve the problem of the origin of the moon. The moon grew from magma rain that condensed out of the rock vapor. The moon could have orbited inside the synestia for years, hidden from view, revealed by the synestia cooling and shrinking inside of its orbit. The synestia turns into Earth only after cooling for hundreds of years longer.
Docking request accepted.
The moon's special connection to Earth is because the moon formed inside the Earth when Earth was a synestia. Synestias have been created throughout the universe. We only just realized that by finding them in our imagination. What else am I missing? What is hidden from my view by my own assumptions?
original sound, of course, is absolutely unique. It has an excitement about it and probably an authenticity, a fidelity that will never be achieved by recordings. But what you're hearing now is not real sound. My voice isn't coming from me. It's coming from sounds that were made a long time ago. And what happens if my voice stops? What do you hear then?
Understand the world and explain its mysteries by analyzing the smallest particles of things that exist. And that's given us a certain understanding.
Source. Lampshade, an empty tin can, anything that could make a sound could be doctored by the tape recorder. Together. this is what you end up with. Doctoring natural sound using a new magnetic tape. Music out of the most unlikely visions.
Changes in society affect the changes in music very directly. The fastest happening change now is technology, electronics. But it's just inevitable this is going to get into the music of today and of tomorrow. Let's hope and try and make it for the better.
You're going to see a wizard? Won't you take me with you?
Why, of course I will.
Hooray! We're off to see a wizard!
Oh, My dear friends, you are now about to enter the nerve center to the entire Wonka factory. Ladies and gentlemen, the chocolate room. This is going to be such an exciting day. I hope you enjoy it. I think you will.
On we go!
Chocolate!
I know, you know,
it's a miracle!
A huge musical composition that's going on all the time, without a beginning and presumably without an ending. We are the composers of this huge, miraculous composition that's going on around us, and we can improve it or we can destroy it. We can add more noises or we can add more beautiful sounds. It's all up to us.
Can you believe it? Can you realize that we, that all of us, have actually begun the exploration of another world? Come with us. We are going to the moon. You will be taken along with the astronauts as they explore the unknown, share the thrill of discovery, and expand our understanding of the universe.
The moon is due to have visitors from another planet.
Through the window of the command module, the Earth gently slipped away. Next stop, the moon.
There it is.
Beautiful.
space that watched the blue planet when life began.
In the minds of many was the emerging concept of a new era for mankind on planet Earth. Apollo, in the distant past, had represented dawn.
Next stop, the moon.
There it is.
Beautiful.
The treasure of the ages.
There it is.
And the moon. And the moon.
The lunar age has begun.
Upon men and planet Earth. Now man from planet Earth has made his impression on the moon.
खुश आमदीद कहते हैं.
Hola y saludos a todos.
Greetings and friendly wishes to all who may encounter this voyager and receive this message.
Hello.
Send greetings to the extraterrestrial inhabitants of outer space.
Disneyland original little long playing record, and I am your story reader. I am going to begin now. You can read along with me in your book, like this.
discover the key to the peace of mind and joy for which you've been searching all of your life.
Oh, together this fragile little world in orbit around the sun. Spaceship Earth.
The sky.
Autopilot engaged. Autopilot disabled.
Hola, soy Patricio Ortega, arquitecto de profesión y carpintero mueblista de oficio. Soy cofundador de un pequeño taller de diseño y fabricación artesanal de muebles de autor llamado Maderista. Nuestro trabajo ha sido publicado en diversos medios impresos y digitales, como la Quinta Bienal Iberoamericana de Diseño en Madrid, el libro Nuevos Creativos Chilenos, Diseño de Productos de Juan Pablo Fuentes y la webserie Manufactura. Maderística nace del placer casi infantil de inventar y construir objetos en madera. En su mayoría trabajamos con tableros de pino contraestopado, pues nos hemos propuesto construir con este material, visto como de segunda categoría, muebles de pino. Desde hace algunos años hemos implementado un curso de introducción a la maderística, ya que tenemos claro que nuestro interés no es solo enseñar, sino reposicionar a largo plazo este hermoso oficio.
In all of time, on all the planets of all the galaxies in space, what civilizations have risen? Looked into the light. Asked the questions that we ask.
We know that the galaxy is awash in water. It's awash in organic molecules and complex chemistry.
Secret to finding promo codes for all your favorite websites is here. This button is your short
you realize that we, that all of us, have actually begun the exploration of another world? Come with us. We are going to the moon. You will be taken along with the astronauts as they explore the unknown, share the thrill of discovery, and expand our understanding of the universe.
The moon is due to have visitors from another planet. Through the window of the command module, the Earth gently slipped away. Next stop, the moon.
There it is.
Docking permission requested. Docking.
The treasure of the ages.
There it is.
Man the moon, man the moon.
The lunar age has begun.
Represented dawn.
Next up, the moon.